Well, I pretty much tried all my different stuff, but if you can't beat them, join them. I grabbed what Matt's got over there. I got the same one I bought last year, just a shallow eight, real bright. You can see that water's pretty nasty. And I'll do it just like I did that square bill. I'll crank it a handle crank or two, stop it. This thing's real shallow. It don't go that deep. We can reach out and touch Matt over there. Took me away from my clear water fishing spot to come fish this chocolate milk. There we go. Finally, I cast that same spot, I don't know how long. He's little, but he'll work, he's a bass. My pliers, I got him in the whatchamacallit. Well, as you can see, it's a little baby, but it's a bass. Well, you see, we finally caught one on this thing. Just a bomber. Shallow A. Thing only, it's like, it's almost a wake bait. It barely goes below the surface. And that's, there's so much grass, you can't tell it with all this chocolate milk, but there's grass just under the surface almost everywhere in here. On what you can use. I think I may not need to pause this. I think just a steady retrieve actually gets it down. Slow gets it down there, keeps this thing running so shallow every time you let off it rises up. And yeah, that's a better one. I was just saying that that slow lets it get a little deeper. Oh, come on, that's a little better one right there, boys. He ain't no monster, but he'll work. Oh yeah, come give him a kiss for me. He's still small enough. I'm not sure if that's a male or a female. Yeah, it's fat, it's healthy. Uh-oh. Woo, look at Matt. You guys see that? He caught a way to set the hook, buddy. Think you'll live? Anyway, there's this one. That's probably about almost 2 pounds, pound and a half for sure, maybe closer to 2. Get in that chocolate milk. Yeah, I got scales now. We can weigh that one. Oh boy. Looks like Matt needs to win that giveaway. Get him some new fishing gear. He better start telling his buddies we need 100 subscribers. We got a long way to go. There we go. Persistence pays off. Been cast over here 50 times trying to hook Matt's thing. Finally another. That's one of them good old lures. How'd you get him? Look at that. I didn't hit him on the bank. He done scraped the bottom. Got mud all over his face. That bass, poor bass. Whoa, 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 whoa. Ain't gonna get me on, buddy. Hang on, I'm almost heavy now. I got your eyebrow pierced. Some old mud bass. I got mud all over me. My phone drop in the water. I don't know how water resistant it was, but it's got a little crack in it, so it definitely isn't water resistant or proof anymore. Well, I would have never even thrown this thing. This thing's got mud all over it. I'm gonna leave them. Yeah, my pocket. Yeah, I may go get my little. Yep. See, I never have any luck with that color. Everybody else catches them. And that's gonna show us how to unhook a fish. Well, he hooks himself probably on the finger. Make our bloopers. Shazam! Oh, I need to clean them things up. They're a little rusty. All right. 4 pounder coming up. I'd run my little lucky square belt, but I think it would go too deep. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh man. Whoa. He's on fire. He come to life when he got out of that water. Mud fish, the old mud bass. These aren't black bass, these are mud bass.
I think I got lucky.
That's not something. Coming right back up. But that's also that little jig that I'm not really, it works. But I don't really like that little thing. It's got these two little weed guards.
That's why I like this program.
Matt's setting for giants. I know. I saw you yank. That thing instantly was a flying fish. You went from a bass to a flying fish. And, yeah, 0.2 seconds. Make sure you properly hold that fish since you about killed him setting the hook. Uh-oh. I'm gonna go switch baits. You got like a white and blue, ain't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good one. I think you're going just a touch deeper too. He ate it. I see that, it's all the way down in his mouth. Yeah, I think I got what I'm gonna switch to. I got a man's. It's about, hang on, I'll be right back. I ain't letting you fish without me. I gotta get my man's. This thing works, but I think something will work better. Yeah. Try old lucky here. This may not go deep enough either. But back when we used to go to the strawberry pond, I got something right off the bat. Some of them other ponds, this little man's baby minus one. I used to tear him up. That's what brother, I think one of his biggest bass he ever caught was on one of these at the strawberry pond. This one I may need to actually slow down the retrieve and hold the rod higher because it definitely goes deeper than that one you had. I'm just talking. Oh, I thought I had one. Nobody likes silence when they're watching a bass fishing video. Oh, there. Oh, boy. Yeah, he's little. Well, oh, shoot, it's a catfish. It's a jumping jack flash. No, it's a bass. He's hooked weird. Uh-oh. These are the ones that'll get you. Whoa, 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 whoa. Kinds of 50 million different ways. Oh, kids, they're getting smaller. They're getting muddier and smaller. I put those little eyes on that thing, but that's a little man's baby minus one, baby bass color. Now that time I kind of, this one runs deeper, so I was holding it up and then just kind of steady. That little shallow thing, you had to hold it down and just to keep it under the water. Yeah, we'd be sitting over here in the boat on the bank. The wind blowing over going, that's a good idea to get the boat out. There we go. Oh, that's a crappie. Good size little chunk. Yeah, that's what, that one day Johnny was down here whacking them. Well, look at how yellow that thing is. Yeah, yellowish gold colored crappie. You got white and black crappie. Oh, this thing's had a chunk taken out of him. Look at that. Yeah, that thing was almost dinner. It's something else. Uh-oh, he's dead. No, he's alive. That's it there that we could use. It would catch the bigger ones. See, the just like yesterday, that little square bell I was using, it was catching me the numbers, it was catching them little bass, they're whacking it, but nothing big. I switched to that jig and pretty quick, didn't take long, I caught that big one. And then really, just because I had caught the big one, the only reason I was throwing it at the end, I was about ready to go, I was like, I'll throw it over here. Look at them. And I threw it over there in that by them trees, which I'd already thrown a square bill there a couple times. They come to life once they get up there that tall. That's where that one did me earlier. I was like, which I think all the big ones we've caught out of here were pretty much on top water, weren't they? Frog and hold still. Oh. Felt something, but it's probably grass. So far out there, I was like, I can't tell for sure. Who needs a swim bait? Look at this little rod. You're digging in the mud right there. Come on, stay on. Oh yeah. Oh, look at that mouth. Look at that mouth. Man's minus one. There's what's in here. I didn't need the old swim bait after all, did I? I got a scale, but what do you think? Five?
Close. I'm gonna say four.
Four? What the hell's wrong with you? Get him unhooked and get my scale. I'll prove you wrong. He may be four. Well, I got the bass in my right hand, my pliers in my right rear pocket. Had to stretch there. I think that hook's got him. Okay. He's a little muddy on this side. Yeah, you're right. I think that's only maybe 4 pounds. Shoot, on that little rod, he felt like 10. Yeah, watch my rod there. Don't step on it. That's my. Oh, you can throw it if you want. 4.4. Very nice bass. Junk, I don't even know if I like that scale. It's still recording, yeah. Let's see if we can. We're gonna give this girl, give that one a nice kiss. Whoa! Get out of there. Get out of there. Well, we're gonna go for broke. We tried the swim baits, those weren't working too well. Back to old Lucky. Oh, Matt's got him one. Is that with the worm? Uh-oh, what's over there? Yeah. Yeah. Probably ran right into the mud. Like that swim bait I was throwing. There we go. Oh! Ran right at me about. No, he ran so hard at me, I about lost him. I couldn't keep up there for a second reeling with him. Out on into the water. It's pretty muddy and pretty shallow right where I'm at. Another one they're hitting up here, Matt. Two in a row. This one's skiing, he's talented. He ate it, he wanted it. Watch how he's got a hook down there. Well, trying to get that hook out of the way. I just know I'll end up hooking myself with that hook in my way there. Well, we finally made it to the other side. You can see that's where we were. Over there with the, where the wind was blowing, and bite slowed down just enough now that I'm gonna come over here. Still using, I caught, I don't know, one or two on that crazy chartreuse looking bomber A or whatever, shallow A, whatever it's called. And since then, all my other fish I've caught come on this little guy, Mann's Baby Minus One. That's the baby bass color. They make all kinds of colors that a lot of them work. They make a bass color, baby bass. I don't know, 15 or 20 different colors. They make, actually, there's two or three different lines of the Minus One, the Elite, the ones with the red hooks. And I don't think any of them are quite like the originals back when they first came out. The hooks have kind of evolved and changed to something that they work, but I don't really like them. I don't like a crankbait that when they go back in, these trebles can hook themselves on each other. Probably if I wanted to take the time and fish these more, as you can see right there, I just dropped it in the water and it hooked itself. I don't like that. So it needs like a size smaller all the way around, really, if I was gonna use them a lot, but I don't use them that much. We've made it to, you can tell I'm on the drain here, standing on it, on the dam. By looking at this thing, the water's down almost a foot from where it'll, you know, that spillway will let it flow out. Still trying it. Matt has caught a couple over there on the shallow side, but I haven't caught anything since I come over this way. All my bass have been over there throwing on that other side of the bank in with the, you know, wind blowing in your face. Kind of casting out into the wind and bringing it back. There we go. Now we got a little action going. That's a crappie. It's a good crappie, but a crappie. Take that back. I did catch a bass, I think, over right when I got onto the dam. I just see myself getting hooked. So I like to carry my pliers. Keep that kind of stuff from happening. See you later, little. Okay, we're gonna put a wraps on this fishing trip. Phone went dead, it was in the truck charging, but of course Matt, he's down there, see, he don't know when to quit. But I did catch like two 2-pounders and, I don't know, crappie and maybe another little one while the phone was dead. But anyway, it was a good day overall. Get out of here and try it again maybe on Sunday. Thanks for watching.